So, okay, it looks like. Looks like it's working. Okay, I didn't think it was actually going to go out and get that. So I'm going to wait for a few people to jump on. Right, so let's see. I hope everybody's doing well today. This is Paint with Lovejoy live painting, and we're going to be doing an underwater scene this morning. And I've actually got still working from my phone, still having a few issues getting everything to streamline. So figuring out all of the lovely technical stuff that we've got going. There we go. I'm pulling up chats. I've got it on the other computer as well. All right. I see a few of you jumping on. Thank you guys so much for joining me today. In today's painting, we're actually going to be painting a nice underwater scene, and you are welcome to paint along. Or if you watch this in the replay, you can pause the video at certain points that you need to and kind of move along. So, again, I see more of you jumping on. Thank you. Hopefully, you guys can hear me all right. I think it worked okay yesterday. So, for today's painting, we are keeping the color scheme rather simple. I have white. Let me get it out of the light. There we go. White, blue, teal, and black. And I will be using mainly white and blue for kind of an abstract background. And then we'll be doing a silhouette design of an underwater scene, maybe a turtle, maybe a shark, maybe some fish in there. We might decide that as we move along. And if you are joining me for the first time, I do live close to the airport, so you probably just heard the airplane go by. And usually I use that as a point to just take a deep breath. So, with that being said, and all the craziness in the world right now, let's just all take a deep breath, relax, get ready to paint, smile. So, all right. And it does help if you have an audible exhale, just let it all out. All right, so let's go ahead and get started painting. So I am going to be using the large flat brush. You can also use a smaller flat brush if you like. And then when we get into details, I'll be using a small pointy brush. So again, right now we're using our wide flat brush. Put my paint up here. We're going to start with a really light blue color. So you're going to start with your white. There we go. We're going to start with white and we're going to add a touch of blue to it. So pull a little bit of that white aside. Tiny, tiny amount of blue goes a long way, and we are going for a very, very light blue. And we're going to start with our light colors first and work our way darker. And again, I'm going to go over three brush strokes that I want you to try. I will be using a particular brush stroke for this painting, but you can use any one that you want at home. So first one to try is pretty straightforward, using the full width of the brush. And you create about an inch in space. Another one, and this is the one that I'm going to use during the video, turn it sideways. It creates a smaller line, but we're actually going to be doing angled lines. And then in most of my classes, the most stress-relieving one, literally slap X marks on there, take out any of your frustration, anything that's pissed you off this week, which I'm sure there's things that have, but throw it into your painting. We don't usually solve everybody's problems, or I charge a lot extra to solve your problem, but you can at least feel a little bit better about kind of things in your life after you're done painting. And it's nice just to go through the process of painting and slapping your paint on the canvas. So with this underwater scene, we're going to kind of start kind of in the top right corner. And if you choose somewhere else, totally okay. And we're going to start with our light spaces first and slowly get darker as we kind of get towards the edges of the canvas. And you will notice that I kind of stick with the same brush stroke. So what I want you to do is find your spot where you want the center of your light area to be and just kind of place a big X marks or a big spot where that's going to go. And then from there, I'm going to hold my brush sideways and we're going to make these long kind of radial brush strokes. Almost kind of like a firework or even an umbrella as it opens, but you're creating all these spikes, all these lines, and again, making it a little bit bigger as you're pulling away from that center spot. And I do want you to apply your paint kind of thick, so that way when we do some blending, you actually have enough paint on your canvas that you can blend into it. So just adding a little bit more, and if you have to make your color a second time and it's a little bit darker or lighter than what you were just using, that's okay. The more that you mix paint and the more practice you get, the more comfortable it gets and the easier it is for you to make exact colors. But right now, your brain is taking in a lot of information each time you mix your paint and each time that you paint. So once you kind of have a radial center of where your light area is going to be, and if you are used to some of my other videos, this is the point where you would take a progress photo. But we're going to make a slightly darker blue now, and again going around this radial area and working our way towards the edge of the canvas as we get darker and darker. So you want to take that same blue that you were just using and add a bit more of your darker blue to it. And your shade may be a little bit different than what I'm using, but as long as it's maybe one or two shades darker than what you're using at home. And I'm going to keep with that same brush stroke. Sorry, hopefully that truck out there wasn't too loud for you guys at home. And I am overlapping the area I was just painting on, as well as extending it into the rest of the canvas. And again, I'm applying my paint pretty liberally, so that way we can do some blending. And if you're painting right now and you're holding your breath, take a deep breath. It's also a time when the plane passed, another good place to take a deep breath. Now, if you are painting on a stretched canvas, I'm painting on a panel right now, but if you're painting on a stretched canvas, when you reach the edge, carry that color around the side of your canvas, around the top of your canvas, and when we get to the darker ones, same thing for the other sides. That's completely optional, but it does look really nice when you hang it on the wall and that color wraps around the edge. So one thing you may be wondering is we've got this kind of nice definition, this nice border right here. I don't necessarily want that in my painting. So what you can do is actually grab your medium brush, tiny amount of water on there, again, never dripping wet with water, and right where that border meets of those two colors, with light pressure, and maybe every now and then you have to wipe your brush back off, but you can blend the two colors together. And this is one of many options for blending. So if you're finding that you already had a blended edge and you don't need to do this, you can skip this step and just kind of hang out while we're painting. You can always grab more of that lighter color, that lighter blue, and bring it back into there. And plane again, so take a deep breath. If you are inclined to finger paint, it is actually quite fun to finger paint, so go for it. And all you're doing is just kind of rubbing the two colors together. And there is something very satisfying about finger painting and just kind of getting dirty and being a kid again. All right, so not too bad. I'm gonna actually go back to the large brush and we're gonna go a little bit darker as we make our perimeter around here, and then we'll be going a little bit darker for that final section. All right, and I see a few more people jumping on. Thanks so much. Happy to have you here. Hope you're doing well. All right, so going a little bit darker, still keeping with those angled strokes. And as I look at it, I realize I wanna go a little bit darker. So feel free if you want to adjust your color even after you've put two or three strokes on there, go right ahead and do that. This is your painting and don't let anybody else tell you otherwise. All right, again, applying it kind of generously and extending it out past that area. All right, you guys are doing a great job. And again, if you realize you're holding your breath as you're applying, don't do that. We need you to breathe. So I've found that if you are nervous and if you exhale as you touch the canvas, it makes it a little bit easier. So maybe give that a try. All right. And another plane going by, so take a deep breath. All right, and then same thing as before, if you would like to soften this line right here, you can again either use your finger and blend which given circumstances today, I'd say be a kid. Just get dirty, you can wash your hands. We are all learning to wash our hands right now. And again, if you don't want to do that option, you can take the smaller brush, no paint on it, just a touch of water, and kind of soften those areas. All right, so your call. And again, if you're watching this as the replay at home, you can pause the video if you're doing this live with me. Hopefully you're keeping up. If not, just kind of enjoy it and go back to painting. So now I'm grabbing my darker blue, and I'm actually almost at the point to where I'm using just my straight blue. But again, you want to go just darker than what you were using at home. And if you feel like adding teal or purple into your water, into your background, feel free to introduce those extra colors. All right. And again, I'm keeping my canvas in the exact same position for you guys at home. But if you need to turn your canvas sideways in the easel, turn it upside down. If you need to put it flat on the table, adjust for what you need at home. All right. And if you have kids at home, these are great activities to do right now while so many kids are not in school. And again, I will be doing this every day at 11 o'clock. Because it gives me something to do during this time frame and hopefully can help give your kids and yourself, the kid and everybody, something fun to do during this kind of crazy, weird pandemic. All right, and here you can see actually, instead of picking up the brush or using my fingers to blend, I'm just using the same brush and light pressure. Again, the more that you do this, the more your brain is taking in the information of what you're doing. Your muscles are remembering what it feels like for the pressure of the brush, for mixing your paint. So be kind to yourself as you're painting, no matter what stage of a painter you are. If you're a first-time painter, a beginner painter, or advanced, you must always be kind to yourself. Because you are learning a new skill, you are pushing yourself out of your comfort zone, and that's a good thing, but it does take a little bit to... I'm seeing some chats coming up. All right, I'm gonna have to look over here, see if I can find it on this one. Thanks, guys. All right, so you do wanna do whatever you want to your background right now. I'm actually gonna go back to the center. I'm gonna clean my brush really good. And I'm gonna go back because I wanna make this just a little bit lighter. So I'm gonna move down to that small brush and my paint is still wet on my background. So that's what helps. Helps with some of the blending. So I am grabbing a huge glob of that white, gonna slap it right there on the center. And if you can see it at home, definitely kind of interesting. And then I'm just actually gonna blend it into those lighter colors. And again, this is another good place to get comfortable with your wet on wet blending, with your pressure, and just kind of even seeing how the colors mix together. Sorry, I'm trying to get my hand out of there for you. And keep in mind that I am painting sideways and looking at the reverse image on my phone and trying to see this sideways. So if you ever want to challenge yourself, and it's a tool that we used to do in college at an art school, you would have to paint something upside down or you'd have to paint something while looking in the mirror so you're seeing the reverse image. And what that ends up doing is just kind of breaking up your brain, the perspective from your brain, so you're seeing it fresh, seeing it new. And once you really get into painting, you'll realize that your brain fills in a lot of details while you're painting. So tricking your brain with that new perspective. So I want you to go ahead, get your background to where you want it. And then we're going to move into black paint and we're going to put kind of a ground on here. We'll put some coral in there and even some, maybe a sea turtle, maybe a marlin or a shark. We will see. I do have a similar video on my YouTube channel and it's a sea turtle silhouette. And I'll push you through a very similar process to this and we'll do the sea turtle on top of it. So given that everybody is at home so much, these are great things to kind of do and fill up the time. So I'm actually just looking at any chat messages, and giving this a moment or two to dry, and then I'm gonna move into black paint. There we go, that's what I was looking for. All right, so again, thank you guys so much for joining me. This is only my second live feed ever, so I had some technical difficulties the last couple days. I'll be working on fine-tuning and figuring those out after class today. And yeah, just keep going from there. But I will be here every day at 11 to show you a new painting. And I will try to keep it at about 30 minutes. That seemed to be pretty good for yesterday and kind of a nice break in the day. So I would actually recommend that you let this dry a little bit longer, but I'm gonna go ahead and move into the underwater scene, and we're gonna get our base for our coral, kind of the ground on there. So I am moving to that medium flat brush and black paint. And again, the bottom of the ocean comes in so many shapes and sizes, so it doesn't matter if you have coral or an underwater cliff on the edge of your canvas, just on the bottom. Maybe it's everywhere, maybe it's circling the entire perimeter of the canvas, and then you're just putting your sea life in the center. But again, your call, make this yours, change it up. What I'm putting you through or what I'm recommending are merely suggestions. So I'm gonna go with kind of just the bottom of the coral reef. And I like to just kind of throw a little mark right there. It's maybe about 4 or 5 inches from the bottom, doesn't have to be exact. And then I kind of do the same thing on the other side. That one's maybe about 3 inches up. And this one, compared to what we did yesterday, I'm gonna make kind of imagine that it's like a little cliff, a little shelf under the ocean. So it doesn't have to be straight, and I did have it kind of shoot off on the bottom. And then same for this one. Maybe it shoots off, maybe it doesn't connect to the other one. Maybe we have another weird little shelf up here. So kind of looks crazy right now, that's okay. Then we're gonna go and fill in with black in each of these areas, and then we'll start getting into the, the coral and the fans and the tiny little fish. Totally had a brain fart for a minute. So as you're filling this in, you can actually apply that black paint pretty thick, and we're gonna be filling in that whole area. And because I am painting this quickly, my blue is still wet. So I'm seeing a little bit of it show up as in the black paint. So all you have to do is just apply your black paint a little bit thicker, and possibly after the video is over, do a second coat of black on your painting. Again, you're just getting great muscle control and memory and getting comfortable with the process of painting. Because I think you will find that this is a very healthy outlet to have. And given our way of the world, no matter what decade or time frame we're in, we do need more calm human beings. And painting is a good way to kind of help calm your everyday mind. I do feel like when I paint, the rest of the world kind of ceases to exist for a few hours while I'm painting, and that's definitely a good thing. Same when I teach my classes in my studio. Most of my students can't believe that 3 hours just flew by and they could continue to paint, but I do kick them out of my studio at a certain point. All right, so once you do have kind of your rock formations or your coral somewhere on there, we can start putting our animal designs. And again, practice, be kind to yourself. And you can practice on a scrap sheet of paper, or you can do this painting multiple times, and you will see yourself get better with each time. So now I'm thinking that we have kind of some coral, maybe some seagrass in there that just floats along. And again, using kind of light pressure, imagine the sea life that you see under the water, what it looks like, just a general idea. It does not have to be perfect, does not have to be exact. But use your imagination. You are an adult kindergartner, or if you're one of my kids that's painting with me, you're an awesome kid because you're fearless and you have no problem diving in and painting what you think, what you see from your imagination. So just keep doing what you're doing and show your parents how to do it if they need help. All right, so again, we're adding our coral, our grass in here. Let's see, maybe some kelp. So I'm gonna put kind of a long stem in there, and then we're gonna put some leaves off of that. And for the leaves, you can actually use the pressure of your brush. So I'm using a little bit wider pressure, or a little bit more pressure, and that makes my brush stroke a little bit wider. And I am reloading the paint just about after each brush stroke, so that way I don't have to do it a second or third time. Nice. And again, these are underwater, so sometimes they do look like they're dancing. So don't judge yourself as you're getting these done. Just be very proud of yourself for actually painting. And then I want you to paint again. Join me tomorrow for, we're gonna be painting a sunflower tomorrow. And on my social media feeds or even leaving a comment below, let me know what you want me to paint in the next week or two on some of these little live feeds. If you get to the point that this is getting too much with a small brush, you can let your background fully dry and you can use a black Sharpie marker to complete your painting. So it doesn't really matter what you choose, just find your creative outlets and whatever materials that you may have. Again, if you're finding that your hand is shaky as you go to touch the canvas with your brush and your paint, take a big exhale and then touch your brush to the canvas. Or if you actually talk or sing while you paint, that kind of makes sure that you're still breathing and it helps with the process. Even if you hum, I'm not much of a singer, so I'm not gonna sing for you guys, but even if you just kind of hum a little tune, it makes it fun. All right. So if you want to start adding fish or your underwater elements, you can. And little fish, again, we're just going for a silhouette and maybe a little tail. So it's almost like a little teardrop with the tail. They do swim in different directions. We have our little school of fish. If you want to put a little seahorse on there, go for it. Anything that you might want to do and you're not quite sure how to draw it, you can Google your subject matter plus silhouette or window decal, but Google's a awesome, awesome resource and you can look at on the screen and then draw what you see. All right, let's get a few more fish checking this one out. All right, let's get a shark in there. So he's gonna have a bit of a longer body. And again, does not have to be perfect. Maybe this could be turned into a barracuda. You gotta give him his little typical shark. They usually have a little fin down here. Another one back in the corner. Oh, let's fix his little butt. There we go. All right, let's see, ooh, sea turtle. All right, we can do a sea turtle. So sea turtle, and I do this in my other video, you're gonna start, let's see, let's have him coming over here. You're gonna start with the shell, and I kind of draw, it's almost like a flattened or sideways teardrop where it's a little bit pointy where his butt is and a little flatter where his head's gonna go. And I'm gonna leave kind of the wireframe outline as I draw it before I fill it in. And then we get the head in there, little half circle on that. And remember, turtles come in many shape or many sizes. So if they're bigger or smaller than what I'm drawing, that's okay. I'm gonna go ahead and fill in his fin right there. And again, I'm looking at this sideways as I'm painting it and then checking to see what it looks like on screen. So feel free to laugh at me if it looks a little funny. Art is not meant to be taken so seriously, and many of my students take themselves way too seriously, so I have to make them laugh. All right, so we got kind of a beefy little sea turtle on there. I'm gonna fill in his shell and his face. If you'd like to add more sea turtles or a family of sea turtles or sea turtles kissing each other, please make it your own. All right, let's work on that little arm right there. He needs a little beefier arm. Okay. Yep, he's a good swimmer. All right, let's see. Let's maybe do I think our shark might need a friend. Or let's see, I'll fill that in. Any suggestions? A few of you threw up a few comments. Let's see, we're gonna make this guy's arm a little bit longer. And let's see, let's do a little baby sea turtle behind him. I actually paint sea turtles quite a bit, so they are my go-to. All right, we'll get a starfish and a seahorse in there. Thanks. We finished that little turtle. Aw, cute little guy. He's very well fed. He's a little plump. All right, starfish. Let's get him hanging out over here. Again, we'll see what your skills are for a five-pointed star. And again, the starfish kind of go in multiple directions. Their arms move. So you can even, there we go. You can kind of see that, yeah. If you're using a marker, you could do that old school five-pointed star that you draw and then just kind of fill it in. For our little seahorse, let's put him over here. I do like to kind of just draw an S with his little curly Q with his tail going back, and then give that top part of the S. You can kind of see it. We got to fatten up his little belly. There we go. I'm going to give him a little bit of a crayon and some spikes. And as you're painting some of your smaller details, if you're noticing that your brush is making wider strokes than it was before, a lot of times you might get a lot of buildup where the base and the brush bristles meet. So wipe that off, maybe clean your brush off, and that will bring the bristles back together. And then again, play with the pressure of your brush to make those smaller lines. Right. Adjust this little guy's tail. All right, and you're welcome. Thanks for joining me today. Let's see, we need something over here. Let's get maybe more of a bigger kind of, maybe an angelfish. There we go. All right, so for the bigger fish, if you almost make like a backwards D, that kind of helps. And then you can give them a little bit of a tail. And I'm going to go ahead and fill in that D shape. All right, it's actually almost like a discus fish. And then if you want, maybe give them a little bit of lips so he can eat. And then those angelfish do have those nice little extra flowing lines. All right. Nice, and we're doing pretty good. I think I kept it at almost about 30 minutes. We got a few minutes left. And like I said, you can add as many animals, as few animals, anything that you might want. And you can use Google to search silhouette designs. And then also check out my other videos on my YouTube channel, as well as Paint with Lovejoy, my website. Also, please send me pictures of what you paint so that way I can post those on social media, encourage other people to paint, share the word, share the experience, spread the word. Because we're all kind of going through this crazy time right now. So let other teachers know, let other people with kids know about my videos, so that way you can stay kind of creative and happy as we're home right now while all this passes. And if you are inclined to continue to help these videos and help me produce them, feel free to jump over to my Patron page. There is a link down below, and donate $5 a month, but basically buying me a cup of coffee every month. And those funds will actually go to help make more videos and keep this going. Because all of our small businesses and artists are deeply, deeply affected right now with the economy shutting down. And there's going to be a lot of changes in their lives, including mine. once all of this passes with the world and the economy. So support your local businesses, keep us going, and find creative ways for you guys to paint at home. And check us out for tomorrow. I will be painting a sunflower. And we'll leave suggestions for what you want later. So thank you guys so much for joining me today. Thanks for allowing me to grow with this and learn new things and all the technical challenges. I really do appreciate your support and showing up today. So have a great day, and I will see you guys next time. Cheers.